Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumper.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem. All right, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. This week, we've been talking about how to match up data from two different worksheets. They have one field and column, for example, customer. Customers and forecast here. Customers, order, cost, and gross profit there. Not the same list of customers on both sheets. So, yet another way to solve this is a very, very old feature, a feature that's been around since, well, for a long time anyway. I know it was in back in Excel 93, which wasn't called Excel 93, the one before Excel 95 had this feature. I remember using it back then. It's called the Consolidate feature. It's on the Data tab. So, we go to Data, Consolidate. You actually want to start in a blank section of the spreadsheet. This is where our output report's going to go. So, come here to Consolidate on the Data menu, and we're going to build references to both sets of data. So, the first reference here is on the forecast sheet. We'll click Add, and then the second reference, I'll click on the Orders tab. Make sure that it has the same left column. So, in both cases, customer was the left column. I want to use labels in the top row and left column, and click OK. And you see that very quickly, without using the multiple consolidation range of the pivot table, we get customers along the left-hand side. It's a superset of all customers that appear in either one list or the other. And then, very nicely here, they don't alphabetize. It shows up in the exact same order that we added things. So, forecast first, and then order, and then cost, and then gross profit. Now, one thing in the pivot table, we had a couple of annoyances here. Of course, we need to put the customer heading in. For some reason, it doesn't put that heading in, and then we have lots of data that show up as blank. I would like to have zeros in there. Great trick. I'm going to choose all of the cells that are blank, the cells that are that have numbers, and then use Go To Special. Now, you can always get to this using Control G and then clicking Special. Now, in Excel 2007, over here on the right-hand side, find and select Go To Special, and I'm going to say that I want to select just the blanks within that selection. So, now I've selected only the blank cells, type 0, Control Enter, and I've filled in all of the blanks with a 0. So, using the Consolidate feature, this is not high tech, it's been around forever. I think it's very unused, something we don't use a lot. The Data Consolidate feature certainly solves this problem and does it very quickly. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.